We set disasters up to like max.
Yes.
And
There's a river near us that floods literally constantly.
there's a drought near us that's going on constantly.
Yes. Which at that point, I'm pretty sure that's just the state of those places.
Yeah. No, we're not ending the world in nuclear warfare. We're merchants, I think.
Yeah, we're merchants.
I don't know if there's a. I don't think there's a like a money win.
Cities of stone, casinos of
Ah.
empires. So we might have to start.
I don't know how we're going with.
We might have to start using our money to buy nukes.
Okay.
Yo, Hojo Togemune has Triforces on his shoulders.
You know, I'm pr when we get around to playing Ace Attorney, I will definitely make better legal counsel than I am as a royal advisor.
Implying that Ace Attorney is valid legal counsel anyways.
True. I mean, like, as your screen share assistant for Ace Attorney.
Embrace the divine wind. Okay, what's going on? Right, Kyoto.
Because at least I actually know how Ace Attorney works.
Kyoto at the top of the map. Osaka, Sendai, Tokyo. Oh yeah, Cahokia is down there. Okay, I'm starting to recall things. Didn't we have another?
I think we had another thing somewhere else.
Tokyo's kind of our farthest. I don't. On the map, I don't. Is there a way to pull up a bigger map? Show full screen map. The only th no we only have four we only have four cities. I thought we did something. I thought wait no we're don't weren't we? I thought we were on
We were
our
doing
way to.
something.
I thought we were on our way to put something over here.
Possibly.
What in the world do we have
Maybe
here?
we should have rewatched the old video
But that would
before
be
we.
boring.
It's more fun this way. It's more fun to be bad at things.
Mitla's over here. Right, this volcano's been exploding. Oh yeah, Rome is right, I remember Rome. God, okay. Okay, well, let's see what happens. Trade with. Okay, Cahokia is upgrading things. Merchant trader. Valletta. Can't we? We're leading in culture. Oh, I know. We're second in. No. We're not. Li No, we're leading in religious. We're second in culture and domination. Do you remember any religions we did? Because I don't.
I also don't remember any religions we did.
Tech tree, civics tree, religion, Nixism, crab, river goddess, amenities and housing to cities if they have a holy site district adjacent to water. Religious. Oh. Each campus or commercial hub. Right, so yeah, we're. Right, we're focusing on like a bunch of districts, is what we're doing. Kyoto, what are you doing? Wait, no, Sendai. What do we want Sendai to make? Recommend walls, and that's actually not a bad point because that's the closest city to other things.
Go ahead and get some walls
Yes.
in there.
Also, my mouse is okay. That's better. Kyoto, right? We made samurai. Do you think we should send the samurai over to protect Tokyo? Or. Because we have archers here. We have warriors here. We have spearmen here. Tokyo has a boat. Oh, and
Maybe.
we have a trader out there. Where were they trading with? Hoklaw, maybe? I don't know. Okay, what should we do with our samurai? They're our strongest fighting unit, and basically only one.
Which place seems to be under the most threat?
I mean, under the most threat, technically, Sendai. Yeah, Nyx is fine. I did not hear him, robot. So, I have no clue.
Wow, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Oh, good.
Hi. Kyoto.
Hi, buddy.
Yeah, so, Nyx, where should we send our samurai? Come on, you're my royal advisor. Where do the samurai go? I will say Sendai and Osaka are under the most threat, quote-unquote, but Tokyo is probably the most vulnerable being off that way. So basically anywhere besides where they are.
I need to get away from my computer, bud. Sorry, can you repeat that? I was trying to get Norman off of my computer.
Sendai and Osaka are the most, like, under threat, technically, because they have stuff right here next to them. But Tokyo is kind of the most vulnerable because it's the most off on its own.
I would say probably send them to Tokyo unless the other two are, like, actively under attack.
Yeah, they're really not. I think Cahokia's are merchant friends, and Rome hasn't really done anything bad to us, I don't think.
Exchange.
Trajan? We're unfriendly, but we have no grievances. How much money do we have? We get plus 33.3 every turn. You know, we could secure, we could send a delegation with a gift, and they'll be a bit friendlier.
That would be a good idea.
Because we have money. One thing we do have is money, so.
Yeah.
Okay, it doesn't accept. Well.
Damn.
Cusses, reasons to go to war. No. View gossip you've overheard. Rome is worse, worshipping a pantheon of the gods, focusing on religious settlements belief. You got plus two. Respects. Oh, so the main reason he doesn't like us is that we don't have a lot of land. I remember he was like telling us that we need to settle more.
Ah.
Okay.
We might want to work on that.
Yeah, you know. Let's Okay, it'll take him 7 turns to get over there. They're going to take a boat. Where's the archer going? Archer, you fortify there. Kahokia Knight is going to. Who are these? Valletta trader. Okay, interesting. Okay, so Ahsoka, we can build a shrine, an aqueduct, an amphitheater. Yeah. It wouldn't really be worth it to build a wonder right there. Yeah, so I'm gonna say probably choose between the shrine, the amphitheater, and the aqueduct. The shrine would take the least amount of time. The aqueduct would give us up to 6 housing. Housing built a chain. Don't have an wouldn't get an amenity. An amphitheater would give us culture, a new citizen slot, and we'd start getting great rider points to get a great rider.
Oh, sir.
Yeah, basically, shrine would increase our faith.
Do we want to go, like, all in on religion? Because we're already kind of leading in that, and can't you win that way?
Yes, you can make a religious... I think you make a religious victory if you convert every other civilization to your religion.
Ah.
So yeah, shrine would give us basically a boost to religion, as well as a citizen slot, and a great profit point per turn. Amphitheater would give us culture and great rider points, and aqueduct would give us more housing. And would also prevent food loss during drought.
Considering that we have disasters turned all the way up, the aqueduct might be a good idea.
The drought that was going on was all right, like, here, I think. Mm. And I haven't seen another one, I don't think.
Ah.
So, yeah, it's your choice.
I don't know, probably the shrine.
Yeah, yeah, that's probably
a good
bet.
It only takes 4 turns.
Yeah, it is the short one. Why are there barbarians here? Okay, well. I'm gonna move the archers there to try to shoot at them, hopefully. The samurai can't attack from boat. You guys continue on your way. Run away from the barbarians. The archers can handle them. God, why does Rome have so many things right here? Horseman, heavy chariot, warrior, man-at-arms, and spearman. Rome might be about to... I think Rome and Cahokia are having a disagreement.
Kinkies.
God. I'm sure it's fine. Probably.
It'd be fine.
Oh, that might be bad for our traders that are coming in. Oh, nope, they're chasing... Okay, that should be fine. Oh! Barbarians, please don't sink our... Okay. World Congress. Session. What are we doing? Okay. We have a lot of diplomatic favor, actually. Trade routes sent to the chosen player... +4 gold to the sender chosen player receives +1 trade route capacity. That'd be pretty good.
Ooh.
Cancels any international trade routes between other civilizations and the chosen player. And embargoes any new ones from starting. Trajan prefers that outcome. Interesting. And then, producing, purchasing military units using the chosen currency type is 100% the cost until the next World Congress. Or 50% the cost. So, basically, we don't want this because we run on trade routes, and I have a feeling Trajan might want to choose us.
Yeah.
So we definitely want this one. Sent to the chosen player, provide +4 gold to the sender, chosen player receives. So we'd probably want that on us to get another trade route. Even if more people get gold for sending to us, you know, it'll encourage people to send traders to us anyways, which helps.
Yeah.
This one, I mean, purchasing military units using the trade. And then we just have to choose which currency type if we want to do this one, because... +100% the cost. I'm not sure what Rome's been using the most or what he'd want to use, but for this one, we could at least try to sway it in a currency that we have a lot of.
Yeah.
So we're in agreement. Vote yes on this one. And choose us. And we can add votes for diplomatic favor if we really want Rome to not do it. Nyx, how many votes how many points do you think we should spend on votes to get that to happen?
I don't know.
Come on, Nyx, you're my royal advisor.
I don't remember what any of this means.
We're just making rules. I have 43 diplomatic favor points just because I'm friends with certain people. And I can just give myself extra votes in this vote.
Well, we super don't want Rome to fuck our shit up.
Exactly. So...
at least a little bit.
You know. You spend another 12... How about we put in 3 votes for it?
Okay.
And then for this one, that's fine. Probably spend gold, because we have lots of gold.
Yeah.
And we don't super care about which way this one goes.
Yeah.
So. Choose outcome A, try to just play it. And submit. Oh. That's a moderate flood over... Where is that? That's... I don't know where that is. Wait, that's that's Tokyo. For some reason, I thought it was over the other way. Okay, both passed. Okay, yeah. So the only one who voted against it was probably Trajan. And we got it for that. And this one, okay. So and this one passed too, but it was selected for production, which is whatever. Ooh, and we got machinery. We can make siege towers, crossbowmen, and skirmishers.
Fancy.
Exact amount. Okay. Oh. And we got a civic for recorded history. So that's our policy thingy, where we can add stuff. Governors provide one loyalty for... influence is probably... Influence points towards earning city-state envoys. Do we want more envoys to get bonuses from city-states, or do we want more loyalty in cities that have governors? Essentially make... Well, so the thing that's bad about loyalty is if someone enforces loyalty on our city-state or on our cities, we can lose those cities to them.
So there's
a system that if a city is far away from your other cities but close to an enemy city, they'll slowly start putting pressure on it, like their cultural pressure, and eventually that city will just flip to belong to them, which is very bad.
Yeah, that's not good.
And the envoys, I think we're already ahead on envoys, so Praetorium?
Yeah.
Okay, and we also got natural policy. Campus district adjacency bonus. That would be good, but our two other oranges are already plus gold from trade routes and plus one housing in cities with two districts, and we are focusing on districts, so.
Yeah.
Campus district adjacency bonus is good, but it's not. I think we already have better policies there.
Yeah.
Yes, there's our policy agenda. Now, fire. And, oh god, hey, our samurais might be about to die. They can't get away.
Oh no.
Best I can do is put them because the thing is, if they try to run, these barbarians are just gonna attack them over here and then get away. At least if I put them there, there's a chance they don't die, and they can get on land while the archers still shoot at the barbarians.
Yeah.
Yeah. How did they do so much damage to our samurai? It's also on a coast tile. Don't we have a bonus on coast tiles? It's just because we can't attack them, because samurais can't attack from boats. Dumb thing. Okay. What do we want to research? We just finished machinery. Next, we can go for cartography, construction, education, military tactics, printing, or stirrups. If you're interested in any of those sounds, then, you know, I can tell you more about them. Our two recommendations right now are military tactics and construction.
Construction sounds like it might be a good idea. Yeah, I don't know what that specifically does.
It's only three turns. It allows us to build a new wonder, which is if we have a chance to, we might as well. But it also gets us a lumber mill, which gives us more production. So essentially, if we have a woods tile, we instead of destroying it to build a farm or whatever, we can just turn it into a lumber mill, and it gives us production.
That sounds like a good idea to unlock the ability.
We have quite a few woods tiles in general areas. We have one there, and we're going to get these two relatively soon. Okay, and which civic do we want to go for? So we have two that are only one turn, which we might as well get out of the way, probably. We have military training, which gives a... Well, the thing is that we don't have military slots, so... but it will give us an envoy. Both of these will give us an envoy. Or theology, which will give us holy site.
What envoys are?
So each envoy you have, you can send it to a city state, and for 2, 6, and or 2, 4, and 6, I think, envoys in each city state, you get bonuses depending on what kind it is. So I think
those things.
Yeah. So for now we have for Cahokia, it's 1 and 3, and we have 5 envoys in it, and the 6th actually gives us another thing. But we get bonus gold for Cahokia. And once we get one more, we get plus 3 gold for every bank and shipyard.
Ooh.
And we get a unique bonus for being the best friends with Cahokia. We can make Cahokia mounds, which are gold farms, essentially. Huh. And food. And housing. Basically, really good. I'm actually really happy that we made friends with Cahokia. So, which do you want to go first, military training or theology? Each one would give us about the same things, but one is military-focused, one is religion-focused.
We should probably go for the religion thing.
Yeah, we are going for religion for whatever reason. I've never done a religion victory. I don't know why we're, like, edging towards that.
I don't either.
And the galley, you can sleep.
Probably because you're leaving decisions up to me, and I'm only half tuned into what's going on.
It's fine. Okay. And choose production. Kyoto. Okay, so we can... So let's see. Districts and building. We can build a theater... the recommended ones are a theater square and industrial zone. That's basically it. We could build... What's this name? We could build a quadrium in one turn. We actually can build a lot of things in one turn.
Yeah.
Oh, we could build another trader in 2 turns because we have the slot for it.
We should probably do that.
Yeah, the theater square and industrial zone would take more turns, even if they are recommended. We'd probably want to do a harbor or commercial hub, honestly, next, regardless of these recommendations, because of the way the game is going.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so build another trader. Oh, and we get another governor title. Do you remember the governors?
Yes, vaguely. I know they give a big bonus thing.
Yeah, so essentially we can assign them to a city, and then it takes them a certain number of days to get established in that city. And then after that, hey, thank you for the follow, Ben and Tao. I think that's your name. I don't know how to pronounce it. After they're situated, they start giving their bonuses, which right now we have the financier and the steward. What we might want to do is, since we're going more towards religion, we might want to get Moksha the Cardinal, because he... Religious pressure to his adjacent cities is 100% stronger, so it's twice as strong, our religious pressure of the city that he's in.
That sounds like a good idea. Yeah.
And we do have 4 cities, so we can get 2 more and still have room for them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, we got land acquire new city tiles. Harbor master. Ooh, commercial hubs and harbors. That's probably what we want to go for next, because it doubles adjacency bonus for those.
Ooh, yeah.
That's super good. Yeah, let's go for Moksha first. And assign him... Reyna's here. Magnus is there. Probably Ahsoka, because it would start applying religious pressure on Cahokia. And I don't think they follow our religion yet.
Theoretically, that would probably make it easier to convert them, question mark?
I think so. Influenced by 2 civilizations.
These are my servers. Fun.
Yeah, so they're being influenced by us and Rome right now, so if we put Cardinal Dude here, we'd probably win that influence race.
Oh, hell yeah.
At least I think that's how it works. Remember that I don't know the game very much better than you do.
Yeah.
Yeah, so put in Ahsoka. Because, yeah, that would put 21 up to... because if we put it in Kyoto or Sendai, that would be equal. Tokyo would get... So Tokyo or Osaka would give it plus 8, because the thing is we'd have to trade out one of the other two. And this one's closer to stuff, and his whole thing is pressure. So,
sir, yeah. Buddy, fucking stop it! Don't spit on my starboard.
Listening to you fight with that cat is amazing. Okay. Samurai, please don't die. Oh. Interesting. What do you think of this? He wants 13 iron for 3 gold a turn, and he'll open his borders so we can walk across them if we need to. That's actually not that bad. Because we have a surplus of iron, we'd still have 33 afterwards. And we aren't really... The only thing we really use iron for is samurai, which, I mean, we'd need to build another one if this one dies, but that's not a super big problem.
Yeah.
What do you say, Nyx? Do we accept?
Sounds alright to me. That'll probably gain us some favor with Rome.
Yeah. Yeah, so we'd gain favor for making a deal with them, and also that would be a total of 90 gold after 30 turns, which is not insubstantial. Even though we do generate 46 a turn. But, you know, also open borders, that does come in handy. Especially since Rome is, like, right next to us and right in the middle of everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I can get your little face. Yes, I get your little face. Oh, man. Yeah, you guys are nice. He just lets me manhandle him.
Okay, barbarians just ran. Okay, we're fine. Hey, we got theology.
Yeah, I gave you a little smooch.
Okay, so the only thing we got from theology is scripture, that would be holy site adjacency bonus, which honestly we might want to switch out for insulae, because plus one housing in all cities with 2 specialty districts. We haven't hit that with all of our cities yet, and also holy site adjacency bonus, we're going for holy stuff.
Yeah.
And I think all of our cities that do have a district have holy districts.
Yeah, I think so.
Let's see how that goes. We can change it in literally a turn if it turns out
bad. Why did you make my hand?
Okay, and
I'm gonna give you a hug.
Military training. Yes. Automatically over. Ooh, that's interesting.
Where are you going, dude? Where are you going?
That's not bad. But a person for religious
reasons. You're just gonna lay right there. Okay, that's where you're going.
Interesting. Hey.
What's up?
Do you want to go for civil service next? Because military training would only take 2 turns, but it's whatever. Because we don't have these slots. But this would allow us to form alliance with friends, which would mean we can't go to war with them and automatically have open borders. It would give us a policy that makes our governors with at least 2 promotions provide amenity and housing to the place they are. And it would give us a wonder that we can build that grants us 2 gurus, which help our religious stuff, and theological combat, which is like the influence of the religion is boosted near it and its holy sites.
Sounds cool as hell.
Yeah,
that sounds extremely
nasty. Okay, and do you want to send the last envoy to Cahokia?
Stop walking over where I'm trying to eat, sir. Yeah.
That cat is a menace.
He really is. He just loves me.
Hey, Sam. How you doing? He's been sleeping over there for the past hour. Okay.
He just wants to be very close to what I'm doing.
Okay, do you want to send the last envoy to Cahokia to get that 6? The plus 2 gold in every bank and shipyard?
Yeah, that sounds really good.
Yeah.
What? Fucking stop it. Please.
In these orders,
Oh, man.
Yeah, okay, Archer, you're gonna... Oh, we can upgrade the Archer to Crossbowman with gold that we have 1,000,000 of.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. And Samurai, come back here. Rest to full, and you're going by land. Because I don't like those barbarians. How did those barbarians get up there? Wait, that's a dead end. Kind of. Oh god, they're back. Okay, crossbowmen, fire at the barbarians.
You are a menace.
Okay, we sank one of them.
They
deserve that. Okay. Nyx, where should we send our trader? Do you want to I think our best option might be sending them to Tokyo to just make a road there.
That's probably a good idea.
Yeah, it won't be like a super like profitable route, but that road might save us.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'll take 11 turns, but after that they'll have a road and we'll go a lot faster. Cat wants to lick.
He's a very licky cat.
Okay. Choose production. What am I choosing a production for? This district? What? Okay, samurai, fortify until healed. Production. No, for Kyoto. Okay. So, our district. So yeah, we do have a holy site. We can build a temple in it, which will just give us more faith and stuff. Other than that, theaters and, yeah. So I'd say the two recommendations are good, either a temple or a new district. Which will give us a profit point, a citizen slot, more faith, and a relic slot. I don't know what relics are, actually.
I don't know either. That sounds like some magic shit.
You want magic shit?
I want magic shit.
Sounds good. Okay, who else is... Sendai... Okay, so we have a holy site, a city center. What's this here? Sophia. Okay, basically, yeah. We can either build a temple in our holy site or we can build a campus.
What's a campus do?
Gives us science. Basically.
Do we want science?
It's the science district. Science is a win path. I think if you use science to go to space, you win. Like, you win the space race. Or we can just improve our holy site.
Improve our holy site.
Yeah, that's probably for the best. Be 100%. Holy site temple. Campus or... Ooh, these are pretty good, actually. What are these? Interesting. What else around here? No, that's a Kokia mound. That's that. We shouldn't have put... Well, to be fair, we had to put those there. I'm gonna make a recommendation. So we can either make a campus or an encampment, which are just starting science or war districts. But we could put a commercial hub right here, even though it's not recommended. It would take 10 turns, but it would just help our stuff be better. It would help our money get better, essentially.
I enjoy when our stuff is better.
Okay. Commercial hub and plus 3 bonus is the best we can get right there. Yeah. Commercial hub there. Jadwiga says, I love a leader surrounded by an impressive military. Good to know. I don't know why we got that. We don't have an impressive military, really. What are these barbarians doing? They're just... The four building blocks okay. of the universe are fire, hey, we got construction. And we can start building those lumber mills. We might want to make a builder then, next. Carter military tactics stirrups. Wow, our war advisor, I'm sure likes telling us what to do with these. yeah, so next, just look at these options. Do you see any that appeal to you? Cartography would help with our ships, castles would help with our walls, education would help with our science. Military, engineering, tactics, and stirrups would help with our fighting power, and printing would help with our tourism.
Do we want culture and tourism?
Culture is another type of victory, and tourism, I think, just helps with culture. Because the more tourists come in, the more they experience our culture and take it back to where they came from, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. Also, how are we feeling about our walls?
We have basic walls right now, and nobody's attacking us. I mean, it'd be good to build them up eventually, but for now, we're playing, like, super, super nice with everyone. Like, the person who likes us the least is Rome, I'm pretty sure, and he's, like, still giving us trade deals and stuff, so.
Yeah.
Also, I think we still haven't met someone.
Yeah, there's still somebody that we haven't met. Which is wild as hell.
Yeah, there's one unmet player.
And how are we doing on ship stuff? How are we doing on boat?
Ship stuff, that's, the only real places we can do it are Kyoto, which I think we have a... No, wait, no. We have a harbor in Tokyo, I think. Wait, what? I don't know what I just did. So yeah, we... Yeah, we have a harbor that's under construction in Tokyo, and then we can also build one in... Who am I commanding right... Oh, I'm commanding the galley. Stop that. Galley, go... Oh, no, galley, you're asleep already. And then over here, we have fishing... our fishing boats were pillaged. Oh, those barbarians pillaged our fishing boats on their way over here. We need builders to fix those. But yeah, we can build harbors around in Kyoto. Our other two cities, we really can't. They help with commercial stuff, mostly.
Norman, get off. He almost turned my laptop off.
So, which one are you thinking?
Castles?
Sounds good to me. We'd also get coursers, which is a promotion of light cavalry.
Hell yeah.
And we get culture for Great Wall improvement. Okay, crossbowman needs orders. Go right there and stay alert. Samurai are healing. They can actually take that road. Oh, hey! It's the drought again. In the same place.
Shocking.
Do you think we should found a city right here?
No. Because somebody denied me aqueduct.
Hey, last question. You know Civ 6, kind of. Is there a way to turn droughts into a good thing? Like, to use them for... something? I don't know, because it's hot. Use them for power or something? Why are you Anshin warriors? Why are you so far away? They're gonna get boxed in. Okay, Kyoto Theater Square. I'm gonna make the recommendation of building a builder to fix these two and make a lumber mill here.
That might be a good idea.
Because it's only two turns and we need to fix these.
Yeah.
Where did those barbarians go? Oh, in the medieval era, ends in 8 turns.
Yeah.
I'm gonna send these archers after this caravan because the barbarians are somewhere over here. Yep, they're there. Okay, we got civil service, that allows the alliance, and the temple. Okay. We should probably wait on civil prestige, because none of our governors have 2 promotions yet. I think.
Man is finally on the floor. He wants to be let out, so he's by the door.
I think tiles recover from a drought, give more food after the drought's over. That's how floods work. I forget if that's how droughts work. Okay. Yeah, so if we activated that, only Magnus would benefit from it. And Magnus is in our capital, and they don't really need more stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So, Divine Right. It would unlock a new government style for us. It would unlock monarchy. Plus one housing per level of walls. Plus two diplomatic favor for every Renaissance wall. More influence points. More influence generation. Favor generation. Interesting. Got architecture. Production towards classic wonders. Production towards industrial area. And these are faith buildings. So yeah, Divine Right is fun. Okay, so Divine Right would help with our faith. Guilds would help with our economics and commercial stuff. What victory are we going for? We're going for any victory that we can manage, because basically I barely know how to play the game. Nyx doesn't know how to play the game at all, and I'm listening to what Nyx says. That's kind of the fun of this right now.
I am basically making decisions at random.
Yeah. Naval tradition would help with harbors.
Making educated guesses.
Yeah. Medieval fairs. Hey, thank you, Tennis Chokeski, for following. Yeah, so basically, religion, commercial, culture, military, harbors. There's no way to make a drug good? Well, that's probably fair, to be honest. I would say guilds is the recommended one right now.
Yeah. Probably guilds or divine right.
Yeah. Great merchant point. Industrial district adjacent bonus. This will give us another governor title. Yeah, guilds probably.
Yeah.
Ideally, what victory type would you like? The way that it's heading right now, we are leading for a religious victory. And culture and domination were second in. So, yeah, basically religious is what we're going for, although I don't 100% know how to end a religious victory. Domination and culture are our secondaries, if that doesn't work out for whatever reason. Let's get guilds. Okay, builder. Go there and fix that, please. I think they can fix that. Wait, repair. Thank you. Okay. Go there. Production. Okay, what should Kyoto produce? We have 3 turns on a theater square. We could build barracks or in 2 turns we could build walls around our capital, which would probably be an okay thing. Or we could start on that harbor.
Harbor sounds good.
Yeah, I'd say the harbor and the commercial hub for what we're doing right now. Once we get that overflowing money, we can kind of just do whatever we want. Map out, which one is this? Grants 2 apostles. Built on woods adjacent to a holy site with a temple. It's to found a religion. Oh, wait. Do you want to start building this temple thingy right here? We wouldn't be able to build we'd have to move the builders over here to build the lumber mill, because it needs to be built on woods, but it would give us a wonder, which is cool. It'll give us 2 gurus, and it helps our theological combat and gives us 3 faith.
Hell yeah,
we have 1,000 faith. I need to figure out what to do with that, and it would take us 19 turns, but you know, I think right now we're the only ones that could build it, so I don't think anyone's gonna beat us to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we could. We I can build it there, technically? No, that's a farm there. Remove the woods on this tile? Yes. Okay. How do you purchase an item with faith? Ah, okay.
Citizens may not initiate.
Interesting. We have a lot of faith. We should probably spend it. And I finally just found where you can spend it.
Yeah.
So, charge to heal itself and all adjacent friendly religious units. May not initiate. Make for just once per game may launch Inquisition to allow the purchase of Inquisitors. Per game may evangelize belief to add an additional belief to their religion. This use consumes the apostle. May convert citizens to the religion. Do you want to just make an apostle and a missionary and see what they do?
Yeah.
Sounds good to me.
Probably send those guys to Cahokia, since we're trying to convert them.
Yeah, you know. Okay, this is our theological warfare map. So this shows that these places follow Nixism. This shows what's converting when. So for instance, this city is going to be fully Nixism in 3 turns, and we're pressuring this one pretty hard.
Okay.
So we are pressuring the city-state, and Tokyo is off on its own, so it has basically no pressure.
So should we send them to Tokyo to make sure that it converts faster?
Probably. We'd probably want to send them over to Tokyo. Okay, so...
Why are you here?
Oh, wow, Valletta converts in 4 turns, too. Yeah, I'd say we send them over to Osaka, and then to Tokyo, and then Cahokia will probably be done by then, and we can kind of push them a little bit farther down, closer to Rome.
Yeah.
This is cool. I actually didn't know that there was, like... So the thing
is... It's like a whole separate combat thing.
Yeah, the thing is, I knew that theological combat existed, I just didn't know how they visualized it. So that's
real cool.
Okay, yeah, we're gonna send... You guys over there.
If you knock my water over, I'm gonna be sad.
How do we... Okay. Builder, go here now. And repair these ones. Samurai, go there. Okay, those guys are moving over there. You're right there. Our trader's almost at Tokyo. And trade routes actually help spread our religion too, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, yeah.
They captured our builders.
Oh, damn it.
And that probably... Okay. Let's see what happens. Spread religion. So we'll have 5 cities. After this. So we want to use these guys. Spread. Promotion available. Ooh, okay. Orator, proselytizer, and pilgrim can spread religion 2 extra times. Religious spread eliminates 75% of existing pressure from other religions and gains 3 extra spreads when moving adjacent to a natural wonder for the first time. We don't have many natural wonders around us. I think for now, orator just to spread more times.
Yeah, and I feel like we might want to get extra apostles to send to, like, Rome to make proselytizers, because they're going to have pressure from Roman religions.
Yeah, I actually don't... The thing is, Rome... Oh, hello, Rome. Didn't mean to do that. The thing is, I don't think Rome has an active religion, because it's slowly converting still.
Oh.
Like,
oh, yeah.
Like, even Rome itself, if we do nothing, it'll be our religion in 800 turns. Which is, you know, the point is to slowly spread so it gets more and more pressure, but...
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, orator?
Sounds like a good plan.
And these guys are gonna spread religion. Plus 200 Nyxism.
Oh, damn.
Hey, it's on Nyxism now. Wow, that works fast. Okay, I like that. And I think... I'm wondering if... I think religious units can... enter enemy borders? Either that, or they can enter enemy borders when there are religion. Because, you know...
Mm-hmm.
Because they aren't military units. The whole thing about military units is they can't move forward. But, like, our traitors can, because they're traitors. So I think our religious units either can by default or can when they're converted.
Cool.
Okay, that's interesting. Yeah, let's have... Actually, I have an idea. No, I don't know. Who can... Okay, missionaries.
Oh, you probably can only buy things with faith in cities that are your faith.
Yeah, and the stronger the faith is, the more things you can buy. Because, like, we can... Differences in what districts we have can change it, I believe. Because we can buy gurus here.
Huh.
Just me.
Sir.
So I'm going
to draw my cup off the desk, even though I had it pushed all the way back.
I say we get a missionary in Sendai.
Or a little menace. That sounds good.
Missionary in Sendai.
You are a menace.
And another missionary in Osaka to go down to Cahokia. And
because
we have 600 something faith already. This is what all our faith is for, apparently.
Sounds about right.
Oh, it's wild when you learn how the game works. Everyone will be following Nyxism.
As they should be.
Cahokia has been targeted by a declaration of war from Rome.
Oh.
Well. That's bad.
It's certainly not good.
Thing is, I think since we're Cahokia's friends, we can declare war on Rome. Well, that's a bad thing, but we can declare war on Rome without a warmonger penalty, because we have a reason to declare war.
Sounds about right.
Your devout people believe strongly that your rule is a blessing from the divine. Our progress towards divine right was boosted a lot.
Oh, hell yeah.
Okay, so you go to... Wait. Converts in 30... Okay, send you down to Anshin. Must be adjacent to city center owned by the city. Okay. Sendai can... Okay, where are you making that? Campus, encampment, or commercial hub? Probably. Or we can build a monument. Loyalty per turn in the city. Okay. I'd say choose between monument, campus, encampment, or commercial hub.
Mine only takes 4 turns.
Yeah, it does. And it increases loyalty, so nobody can convert the city against us.
That sounds like a good idea.
Yeah. Okay, so... I don't remember what Launch Inquisition does.
Okay, damn. just pawed in my face. Okay, sir. Quite rude of you. You are a little menace. Yeah, you're a little menace.
Okay. Keeping on that plan.
Fire those.
God, I hate those guys. Okay, so this one, I can go here. Okay. Oh, hey, Valetta converted to Nyxism.
Oh, hell yeah. Time for crab, baby.
Rome's not having fun with any of the city-states.
Is Rome getting its shit kicked in?
No, I think the city-states are.
Damn.
Although it is picking a fight with two city-states at the same time, so that might not end well for him. Actually, wait. Yeah, Rome has not that many forces left. Does have a great general, though. Oh, Rome got Boudica. I don't remember what Boudica does. Rocks in my path. Hey, castles! I keep
them all. Yeah, castles! Then I shall build my
castle. Okay, sweet. Okay, next up... Ooh, we can get the next stage of walls. We can get Renaissance walls. Printing, military tactics. Education, constant contribution. Ooh, cartography would let all of our units go across the ocean tiles, not just coast tiles.
Ooh. That sounds like a good thing to have.
Yeah. Other than that, military engineering would allow us to collect nitre and make military engineers and trebuchets, but we really aren't fighting.
Yeah.
Stirrups would give us plus one food from pastures, which we have a couple of.
That might be nice.
So I'd say cartography or stirrups.
Stirrups long. It takes 5 turns. Oh, yeah. I think that's better to do.
Also, cartography, it gets a bonus if we build 2 harbors, and we're... Tokyo's about to build its harbor, and Kyoto's was going to build a harbor next, so... We can get cartography once we have 2 harbors.
Hell yeah.
Hey, claim great person. We get a great writer. How do we get a great writer? Okay. Okay. It's orders. Okay. So missionary, you're gonna go right here, and spread religion. Okay. Cahokia is Nyxism-ish now.